Rubinstein, one of the foremost artists of our time. Internationally eminent concert pianist, faithful interpreter of the works of the great composers, classic and modern.
Would you like to hear a playback, Mr. Rubinstein?
No, I didn't like it well enough. Let's have it once more, please.
Certainly. Roll take. Artur Rubinstein, Schumann, Aufschwung, take 10.
Although Mr. Rubinstein has appeared in concert halls throughout the world, his largest audience, numbering millions in every nation, is most familiar with his work through recordings. It is this sense of responsibility as an artist, plus the objectivity of being able to evaluate his own work, that brings out the tireless energy he devotes to it.
Rubinstein, Schumann Grillen, take 18, playback. Pleased with that one, Mr. Rubinstein.
Well, I think it's better than the other ones. Well, I think we can press that.
Fine. You've had a hard day. I guess you're glad it's over.
You wouldn't believe it. You will laugh. I have to go home now and practice for my concert on Wednesday.
I don't envy you. By the way, Mr. Rubinstein, there's a gentleman waiting to see you.
My name is Johnson, Mr. Rubinstein.
How do you do, Mr. Johnson?
How do you do, sir? I represent a company which intends to produce a series of films called Personal Record, and we wondered if we could interest you in making a motion picture.
Motion picture? I have been in motion pictures. Haven't you seen them?
Yes.
Well, then you must know that really my kind of music doesn't belong yet.
Ordinarily, that's true, but we're planning a different type of film. No love story, no villain, no horses, no glamour girls.
And no actors, I suppose. Well, I'm not an actor. I'm a musician.
Well, that's why we felt our project would interest musicians. It's a simple plan. Just a half hour of fine music and something about the person, the artist behind the music.
That sounds pretty good. But I still think that musicians should stick to their music. Will you excuse me, Mr. Johnson?
Well,
I must go now. But I will think it over.
While you're thinking it over, how would you like to see a film of Chopin himself at the piano?
Chopin himself? I'd give a few years of my life for that. But unfortunately, in his time, there were no microphones and no cameras.
Ah, but that's my point. Think of what it would mean today if we had an intimate record of the great artist of a century ago.
Yes, there's something in it. Well, will you come to my home this afternoon at 6 o'clock, Mr. Johnson?
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Rubinstein. I'll be there.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, sir.
Come in. Oh, come in, Mr. Johnson.
I'm sorry I interrupted you, Mr. Rubinstein, but your butler told me to come right in.
Not at all. It's quite all right.
Well, please continue with your practicing. I don't mind waiting.
No, I couldn't practice when anybody's around. You see, this is strictly kitchen work.
Oh,
I must be alone. Because if anybody's around, then I don't practice, but I play. It's a great difference.
I see.
You know, in hotel rooms sometimes, when a waiter brings my coffee in the morning, well, I stop practicing, I play something in hopes that he might listen at the door. May I play for you that little piece which I was just practicing?
It'll be a great honor,
well,
sir.
Well, then sit down,
will
you?
Thank you.
Spinning Song of Mendelssohn.
I wonder if you'd forgive me if I made a special request. My favorite record is your recording of Liebestraum. I've played it so often I've worn it out. It'd be nice to hear it without scratch.
All right. Liebestraum without scratch.
Thank you.
And now I will play one of my favorites, the Waltz in C sharp by Chopin. But it's getting dark now, Mr. Johnson. Would you be kind enough and turn the lights on?
Why, certainly.
Well, Mr. Johnson, you came here with a project, and instead of that, I'm giving a concert.
Why, it's been a great honor, sir.
What do you expect me to do in your film?
Just play. We'll put a camera where I was, and you play as you did.
Nothing else?
Well, perhaps in addition, you could tell some personal anecdote, some particularly interesting experience you've had. Or some incident you feel influenced your life as an artist.
Again, acting.
Just tell it in your own words, as you would to me.
I have an idea. Come with me. This is a triptych which my friend Kanarek has painted for our new home. You see, Mr. Johnson, I've been an inveterate bachelor for a long, long time. I believed artists should marry, but I had a wonderful time. I was traveling all over the world. I was meeting so many personalities. I had fun and quite a lot of success, too. But there's no sense, there's no purpose in such a life. I don't know, to enjoy success, you must see it in the eyes of someone you love. someone you can share it with.
Well, here's the story of the five houses where I lived since I married. The top one is in Paris, Montmartre, the gayest spot on earth. And there I did the most intelligent thing of my whole life. Can you see me carry my bride into the house? Well, from that point on, everything had a meaning in my life. See, here, I buy another house in Paris, a house near the Arch of Triumph on the most beautiful avenue in Paris. And here are my babies. I'm very proud and I'm showing off a lot, I think. And here's New York. We arrive on the Queen Mary and we are a little sad. We are a little bit apprehensive. The Germans were in Poland. Oh, but here's Carnegie Hall. Can you see me playing there?
Certainly.
Well, this was a memorable concert. It's the kind of success, you know, you can share. And this represents California. In this house, we had another edition of our two children, 10 years after the first one. You can see the little girl and the baby. And the picture shows my mother-in-law arriving from Poland after those years of war. But we needed a bigger house, so we came down to this one. And here we sit at last and look at me, lazy, happy. I have nothing to do, only 127 concerts, 70 recordings, and now you want me to make a motion picture. So you see, all you have to do is to photograph this thing, and I don't have to talk at all.
Why, that'd be perfect for our purposes. Carnegie Hall. That must have been a great but tense moment in your life.
Oh, it certainly was. I remember every moment of it.
Including the program you played?
The program, yes. I remember the Polonaise in A by Chopin.
Oh, well, as a special favor, would you play it for me now?
Gladly.
Thank you.
Hello, how are you?
Hello!
Come here, darling. Come here. Oh. This is my family, Mr. Johnson.
Good evening.
Good evening.
And this is the last job for the day.
Well, it's getting very late, Mr. Rubinstein. I really must be going.
Well, will you call me tomorrow morning, please?
I will. Thank you very much, sir. Good night.
Thank you very much. Well, children, now I will play for you something, and I think Pop Goes the Weasel is the best.
Yeah! Right?
Yes.
As a tribute to Frédéric Chopin, we take you to the home of Artur Rubinstein, one of the most distinguished interpreters of his works, where Mr. Rubinstein pays homage to the memory of this great master.
Beautiful.
And now, may I play a mazurka?
Surely.
You see, a mazurka of Chopin is the most original and the most Polish of all his compositions. And my Polish accent becomes appropriate in a mazurka.
Thank you.
lovely, Arthur. You've never played it better anywhere. As a matter of fact, some critics believe that Chopin shouldn't be played outside a drawing room. Isn't that so, Arthur?
Yes, they always treat him like a weakling. I don't know why. To believe the critics, I should wear a wig and red heels for playing Mozart, and an enormous beard for Brahms, and for Chopin, I ought to be tubercular, no? No, that's not true. He was not weak at all. He was very strong, on the contrary, in his soul, in his heart. I will play for you a scherzo of Chopin, which takes more strength out of me than any other work I know, the scherzo in C sharp minor.
Thank you.
Do you want some moonlight?
Oh, please.
Well, I will play the Nocturne in F sharp. And now I will play a composition which is the closest to my heart, the great Polonaise in A-flat. Thank you.
The rehearsal was at Rubinstein's house. As I drove up the driveway, I was looking forward to hearing three of the greatest soloists of all time. But I had to remember I was there on business. I'm a screenwriter, and my studio had assigned me to write a script for these three distinguished musicians. I got out of my car and approached the house, still trying to get an idea for the story I had to write. My producer said people wouldn't stand for just music on the screen. A picture has to have a story. But I'd never worked on one in which a trio was the star. I stole over to the window to get a look at my actors off guard. Rubinstein, Heifetz, Piatigorsky, three artists whose names had become synonymous with the instruments they had mastered, together at last. Piatigorsky had interrupted a tour of South America. Rubinstein had been contacted during an engagement in Paris. Heifetz had just returned from a series of concerts in Israel. I wanted a chance to talk with them before they started playing, so I hurried to the door. But the houseboy was trained to anticipate interruptions.
I beg your pardon, gentlemen. Please forgive me for intruding. I'm the writer who's been assigned to your picture.
Oh, yes, we were expecting someone from the studio. But why a writer? Abido, is our picture to have a story?
Of course.
But what kind of a story can you make for a trio? Not a triangle, I hope.
No, Mr. Heifetz, not that kind of a story. No boy meets girl. But the studio does feel that audiences might not appreciate a concert on the screen, even from so rare and distinguished a combination.
It's true. Movies must have action. Do you have something in mind?
Well, I've worked out some ideas. Here are the scripts. But no story conference yet, if you don't mind. I've never seen you famous gentlemen at close range. I have no way of judging which of my ideas is best for you. Would you mind continuing the rehearsal and letting me observe for a while?
Yes, delighted.
Thank you. I found a chair for myself and prepared to keep my eyes and ears open.
We were just running through the Schubert.
Yes, I heard it when I came in. It was perfect.
Thanks very much. I wish we felt that way.
Well, it sounded perfect to me. After all, if three soloists of your standing couldn't play it perfectly, I...
Ah, that's just it. We are soloists. That doesn't make an ensemble.
You see, we are spoiled. We are always concerned about ourselves and our own instruments.
And in a trio, we have to submerge our own individuality. Isn't that right, Bishop?
We search for a link between our personalities.
And wait a minute, what about interpretation? You see, we must feel the same way about a composition. To achieve this, we must, each one, give and take.
Which reminds me, Arthur, the finish of the Schubert. Don't you think we could have been better?
Well, we started crescendo too soon, too.
Certainly. Let's go. Let's try it again. Come on. Agitato, B flat.
Right.
Disagreement might lead to some action. Movies thrive on action. Here was my chance to get some authentic dialogue.
Look
here, if we have to argue, let's argue in English.
Pardon, monsieur. Anyhow, you couldn't use it for the movie, even in English.
In a nutshell, all it amounts to is, let's play it again. Risha, you always complain about carrying the cello, yet you never put it down for a moment.
Why shouldn't I complain? It's all very nice for you and Artur. Wherever Artur goes, the piano waits for him. Wherever you go, this admirer to carry your fiddle. But who can admire a man this much?
Very funny, Grisha. But let's play the music for the movie. Okay.
D minor trio of Mendelssohn. Thank you.
his work to listen. It was magnificent.
Shall we go on?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. The second movement.
Would you like a drink?
No, thank you.
A little water, Arthur?
Yes, certainly.
Yes,
no, thank you very much. Any ideas for the story yet?
Oh, yes, I've got an idea.
Good.
My idea was no idea. This movie doesn't need a story. The studio had said movie audiences wouldn't listen to a concert, but I had just seen everybody with an earshot listening. I threw away the scripts. I stopped worrying about a story and decided to enjoy the music. May I suggest, ladies and gentlemen, that you do the same?
Are you ready?
Scherzo.